Throughout Go Incognito, we've had to take insecure and or unprivate pieces of software and hardware and modify them to our benefit. But are there any options out there that do this work for us? Luckily, at the time of making this course, there are some projects and products I wanted to share with you that aim to offer security, privacy, or both out of the box. It's important for us to support companies and projects that take this stuff seriously and leave behind other companies that don't care. One of the things we do to help spread privacy to as many people as possible is host several communities where you can mingle with other people passionate about privacy and security, like you. You'll find our communities on Discord, Matrix, and Telegram. If you're more interested in staying up to date with our content and projects, we are on Twitter and Patreon as well for more consistent updates on what's happening on our ends. Enjoy the rest of the lesson. Let's start with software. Tor is pre-configured to boost your anonymity. It's offered for free, and the setup is extremely simple. Don't forget about TailsOS and Hunix. The EFF is a wonderful organization who develops amazing software like HTTPS Everywhere, as well as great advocacy. Check their sites for meetups so you can take action with them. Proton gives you a private and secure email, VPN, and more products with a great track record. Search.me, Startpage, and DuckDuckGo are all fantastic search engines. Veracrypt makes file and drive encryption easy and free. Most Linux distributions are private and secure out of the box. Aside from Linux distros, we also have BSD and Cubes. GrapheneOS and CalyxOS are excellent ROMs for Android devices. VirtualBox and KVM allow you to quickly create virtual machines. LibreBoot and CoreBoot offers a FOSS bootloader for your machines. OpenWRT and pfSense both give you FOSS protection on your home routers. And cryptocurrency projects like Monero offer private ways to send payments to anyone around the world. Those are just a few of many amazing projects out there. Moving to hardware, Purism, Pine, and System76 make private computers built from the ground up with you in mind, as well as some phone options. The Ministry of Freedom pre-installs LibreBoot and Linux on laptops, making it easy for consumers to switch to Linux and LibreBoot. The Ledger Nano is a cryptocurrency wallet allowing you to securely store your coins, something we should be encouraging more often. The final and more unexpected device that has your security in mind are iPads and Chromebooks. We've discussed using these in the past for high security and low privacy activities. This includes personal banking, personal email, and anything else that is inherently unprivate but requires a high degree of security. Outside of these larger products and services, we have some smaller items you can buy that we covered on our YouTube channel that we consider small boosts to your privacy and security for very little money, like privacy screen protectors. And that's it. My hope is that some of you watching this course have some programming, engineering, or development experience. If so, I encourage you to make a difference. This list was awesome, but it would be better if it was twice the size. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next lesson, Downsides to Safety.